I grew up knowing about God, never really knew God. I was raised Catholic, was a Sunday church goer, and then kind of just like fell out of going to church and only went on holidays. Got to high school and just really started struggling with identity and didn't really know who I was. And so I started to find my identity in the things that I did. I've danced all my life, and so always felt like I had something to prove to people. Like I had to prove I was good enough. I had to prove that I was worth it and I was gonna be something someday. And so I decided my senior year of high school that I would try out for Tiger Girls. It's the dance team at LSU. And I tried out my freshman year and I didn't make it, and it crushed me. And it wasn't my dancing, it was just the whole look. I was just told to come back next year. I went through my freshman year and really started to fall into partying. I was at Tigerland all the time and started to find my identity in just bars and alcohol and what I wore and who I hung out with and who other people said I was, and never really knew who I was. And the whole time I was walking through that, I still felt empty. I still felt like I was missing something. I knew there was something out there. And so I tried out for Tiger Girls again my sophomore year, going into my sophomore year, and I made it. And that was all I ever wanted. That was like the one goal of my life, to be an LSU Tiger Girl, to have that title for my name. But in that process of becoming a Tiger Girl, I had just developed an eating disorder. It had gotten really bad. Because I was finally skinny and blonde, but nothing had changed, and my friends didn't change, and nothing changed like I thought it would. And so that led to just like a bunch of anxiety and a bunch of depression, and just really struggled throughout that year. That was everything I ever wanted, but that year was nothing that I thought it was gonna be. That summer, I was invited to join a ministry called Fine Lamb, which is a Christian sorority at LSU. And at this point, I was just kind of at wit's end, you know. I was like, this Christian thing, I'm gonna try it out. I'm really gonna try it out this time. You know, like these seem like nice people. And went to the first meeting, and there was this song that came on by Carrie Jobe, who is my favorite worship leader. And it's that song, I Know That You Are For Me. And it says, I know that you are for me. I know that you will never forsake me in my weakness. I know that you have come now, even if to write upon my heart, to remind me of who you are. And in that moment, the beginning of my junior year, the grace of God just fell upon my life. And I can really say that I had experienced the love of God. I think especially in college, it's so easy to fall into that trap of finding your identity in everywhere other than who Jesus says you are. You know, the world says that in order to be cool, you need to go out and party. In order to be cool, you need to get drunk every night, and people need to think you're funny. And I did that. I did all that. And I just would wake up every morning so empty. And the Lord has just really spoken purpose and really given me a hope. I can wake up every day and have hope, and have a reason to live and have a reason to smile. And he's just filled me with unshakable joy and has given me his promises to stand on when I don't think I can stand anymore, because there are days that are hard. Some days are harder than others, but we serve a God who rose from the grave and defeated death. And so he's got you, he's got me. And I wanted to close with Isaiah 55. It's an invitation to the thirsty, and this is God's invitation to you. It says, Isaiah 55, 1 through 2, it says, come all you who are thirsty, come to the waters, and you who have no money, come buy and eat. Come buy milk and wine without money and without cost. Why spend money on what is not bread, and your labor on what does not satisfy? Listen to me and eat what is good, and you will delight in the richest affair. And he is the living water. He's the bread of life. He is the well that never runs dry, and it doesn't cost anything. His love is free, and it's a gift for you and me. And so I just want you to just really walk in that love today and accept that love and believe that it's for you. It's for every single person. So I'm Emily, and that's my story.